إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، my dear honorable ulama, respected khufaz, beloved elders and brothers, and our beloved sisters and children, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah, thumma alhamdulillah, we praise and we thank Allah Ta'ala, alladhi ahyana ba'dama amatana wa ilayhi nushur, who has given us this life after death, life after sleep. Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala has woken us up, and no one in the whole world or universe could have done that favor for us. This is truly a gift from Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. The Prophet alayhi salatu wa salam is the most refined person to have walked the face of this earth. And it's only refined people that look for fine detail. Only a refined person can look at the smallest of things and it looks almost insignificant, but can be grateful on the superlative level of gratitude. We would think waking up is just natural, that we've woken up thousands of times in our lifetime. But the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam teaches us that for this very, which seems like mundane act, normal act, habitual act, it just happens. But the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam is teaching us that this is actually something great that you need to be grateful for. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala caused you to wake up from death. You were literally a dead man and Allah has given you an opportunity. So we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for this wonderful gift of life. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has topped that life off for us with the greatest gift, the gift of La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah ta'ala has favored us to make us of the 2 billion believers in a world of 8 billion people. In a world of 8 billion, Allah has chosen us to be reciters of La ilaha illallah. Chosen us to be followers of Muhammadur Rasulullah. Chosen us for His word, the Kalamullah, the Quran. Chosen us for the words of His Prophet, the Sunnah of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has chosen us to find ourselves in the one of the Ashurul Hurum, one of the months, the holy months, one of the sacred months. Rajab. Allahumma barik lana fi Rajab wa Sha'ban wa ballighna Ramadan. Allahumma barik lana fi Rajab wa Sha'ban wa ballighna Ramadan. Allahumma barik lana fi Rajab wa Sha'ban wa ballighna Ramadan. It is reported, Ameen, Ameen, Ameen. It is reported that the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, that he has said these words, that, oh Allah, bless me in the month of Rajab. Cause me to see this month through, and we're almost at the end of it. We're already at the 28th. We're at the 28th of Rajab. The month is 29 days or 30. If it's cloudy and we can't see the moon, then it will be 30 days. But we are almost a month away from the month of Ramadan. Our pious predecessors, they lived their life for Ramadan. Ramadan was the axis of life for our pious predecessors. They looked so forward to Ramadan that they never started making dua 2 months before Ramadan. Rajab and Sha'ban, then Ramadan. They never made 2 months before the time. It is said about the Salaf al-Salihin, كانوا يدعون الله تعالى ستة أشهر. ستة أشهر. They used to make dua 6 months ahead of time. 6 months before Ramadan, they would already start looking forward to Ramadan. And they would start making dua, Ya Allah, cause us to meet the month of Ramadan. كانوا يدعون الله تعالى ستة أشهر أن يبلغهم رمضان, that Allah must make them reach the month of Ramadan. Imagine, these are refined people like we said. Refined people are seeing things in very, 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 very fine detail. They understand the value of what we take for granted. We have taken the month of Ramadan for granted for 30 years, 40 years, 50 years, your stay on this earth. How many of us don't just take it as another month that's going to come and go? Ramadan will come and Ramadan will go. Just like all previous Ramadans. It comes, it goes, and we go back to the good old days. We go back to our bad old ways. We go back to the way we want to treat Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ramadan is a special time that the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said that لو يعلم الأمة ما في رمضان. If the Ummah knew the month of Ramadan as they're supposed to know it, لتمنت أمتي, and my Ummah would have desired أن تكون السنة رمضان, أن يكون رمضان السنة كلها, that the month of Ramadan must be the whole year. This is the way our pious predecessors, they loved the month of Ramadan, and how they keep Ramadan in high esteem, and how they always looked forward to the month of Ramadan. You ask your youngsters, your teenagers, about the month of Ramadan, and if you can get an honest moment out of them, then they will tell you that they're not looking forward to see the month of Ramadan. They're not looking forward to see the month of Ramadan. They're not looking forward to the Taraweeh. They're not looking forward to opening that Quran a little bit more. What has happened to the Ummah Jamaat Muslimin? People like to say the youth are the future. The youth are not the future. The youth are the now. The youth are the present. If we cannot make an impact on the youth today, we have failed the future already. Islam is finished already. If we don't insert something in them today, yaqeen, iman, Islam, the value of being a Muslim, the pride of being a Muslim, the pride of being an ummati of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then we have failed the ummah. And we have failed with our youth. And we have failed on the mission of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revive our youth. They are our now. They're not our tomorrow. They are our now. If the old people start keeling over, if the old people start falling over, if the heart attacks start happening, if the janazah start pouring out, who is going to stand in this mihrab? Who is going to stand on this minbar? Who is going to make dua for his parents? If we are not doing our duty towards the generation of today, then we have all failed tomorrow. Then we have all failed tomorrow. And the person that fails to plan, he has planned to fail. We need to have a plan, Jamaat al-Muslimin. May Allah help us to find the road. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us, give us the map so that we can find ourselves back on the sirat and be guided back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, back to his deen, back to the Quran, back to the sunnah, and back to the masajid. Back to the masajid. Back to taqwa. We're all looking forward to the month of Ramadan, but have we taken our prize from last year Ramadan? Our prize from last year Ramadan was لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّكُونَ, like it was the prize of your last 30, 40, 50 years of Ramadan. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ, to develop the consciousness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to develop dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to develop tadhakkur of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to develop awareness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to develop ihsan of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. كَأَنَّكَ تَرَاهُ, such levels, it is as if I see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَإِن لَمْ تَكُنْ تَرَاهُ, and if you haven't reached those levels, then what is the least level you should be on? فَإِنَّهُ يَرَاقْ, that is the least level. I know that he ta'ala is seeing me. I can't bring myself to that level. It is as if I see Allah. But at least I should be on the level where I know Allah is watching me. It's difficult for me to do wrong. because I feel this presence over me. I feel this gaze, this tawajjuh on me. I feel this concentration of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on me. Therefore, it is difficult for me to break the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's not easy for me to say whatever I want to say. It's not easy for me to do whatever I want to do. It's not easy for me to lift my hand however I want to lift my hand and move my feet in any direction that I want to move my feet. What does the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam say? That Allah ta'ala says that my slave does not draw close to me with anything which is more beloved to me than the fara'id. A person must first fix his basics before he worries about highfalutin things that he wants to get involved in, complicated things that he wants to get involved in. Are your basics in order? Are your basics in order? Were you in the masjid for Fajr this morning? Your basics in order? That's your basics. Were you in the masjid for Fajr this morning? That's your basics. Not in Fajr in the month of Ramadan. Don't come Amal Masjid too. Were you in the masjid today? Like the six people that was in our masjid this morning. The masjid was full on the 27th of Rajab for the Mi'raj and the Isra program. Did they take any lesson from the lessons that were being dealt out at night about what the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam went to fetch and get as a gift for the Ummah? Because definitely it wasn't seen at Fajr time. At Fajr time you were stuck with the same six people in the Musalla, on the Musalla, in the masjid. The same people. I'm talking about our experience in our masjid, in the locality that I'm coming from. That number doesn't change throughout the year. And the sad thing is, Jamaat al-Muslimin, it used to change during the month of Ramadan. It used to. Now it doesn't even change during Ramadan much anymore. You get a few additions now. But since COVID, our COVID has affected our hearts because of that disconnect that it made with us and the masjid. Now you see people that at least they used to frequent the masjid during Ramadan. They're not even frequenting the masjid during Ramadan anymore. This is where our iman is going. Look at ourselves. And then we need to ask ourselves the question, where are we going as an ummah? Where are we going as an ummah? If even during the holy month of Ramadan, we are starting to fall short, we see it. The big nights are not big nights anymore. I don't know what the turnout was here. But if you've been taking a census of what's been happening in your masjid, and that's what an imam should do, he should be he should be awake, he should be alert, he should be his finger must be on the pulse. What's happening in my community? For who could come mention if a fajri? What did Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala do when that youngster wasn't there for Fajr? After Fajr, he went to his house. This is Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu. If he walks a path, the shaitan takes the other path. If there had to be a Nabi after Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, lakana Umar, it definitely would have been Umar. This is that personality. That is this personality. That person, Umar, took himself out of his comfort zone, went to go and find that youngster, met up with that youngster, knocked on his door. The mother answered the door. Where was your son this morning for Fajr? Oh, Amir al-Mu'mineen. He was so busy on his TikTok. He was so busy on his social media. He was so busy on his Xbox. He was so busy on his PlayStation. I was so busy with a Turkish series, mashallah. I watch Islamic series, mashallah. Huh? Mashallah. Was that the response? That would be today's response, yes. Pass your scene for Fajr. I so busy with my phone. I should dip an iPhone, Imam. Praat samad mekan. No, this mother said, Amir al-Mu'mineen, my son was so busy with tahajjud. He was whole night in prayer. And then near Fajr time, sleep overtook him. When he took his little break, sleep overtook him, and therefore he missed his Fajr with Jamaat. Imagine you could even get a response like that. That would be a praiseworthy response. That would be a praiseworthy response if someone said something about you and said, you know what, he was busy the whole night in dhikr, all night in his Quran, all night in his studies of deen, all night in the khalaqa of dhikr and ilm. Therefore, unfortunately, and we should say unfortunately, he missed his fajr with jama'ah. What was Sayyidina Umar's response? What was Sayyidina Umar's response? MashaAllah, you've got a pious son, MashaAllah. Good son, MashaAllah. Standing all night in tahajjud. Sayyidina Umar said, I prefer to make my salah in jama'ah, my fajr in jama'ah, than standing the whole night in prayer, in nafl, in voluntary prayer, in tahajjud, in salatul layl. Fajr. Fajr. If we can't fix our fajr, how do we think we're going to fix the world? We want to fix the world. We want to fix our province. We want to fix our elections. We want to fix our government. We want to fix Gaza. We want to fix Palestine. We want to fix Kashmir. We want to fix Afghanistan. We want to fix Iraq. We want to fix Syria. We want to fix Lebanon. We want to fix Somalia. We want to fix Sudan. We want to fix all these places. How are we going to fix these places if we can't even get ourselves up from our comfortable beds in the morning and make a sacrifice for the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? You think you're going to sacrifice your life for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala like the people in Gaza? It's easier said than done. It's easy to say, ik haag gewisset, dan het ik hy zijn is gewijs. It's easier said than done. But when the bombs start falling and the bullets start flying and your companions start falling around you, then we will see what your heart is made of. If a person is not making his heart here locally in his own masjid, don't think you're going to make it on the battlefield. Don't think you're just going to make it. Not going to be automatic. You're not going to take a tablet and then suddenly you're going to have the strongest iman. As any tea drink in the Kaapie, who has a tea drink in Makkah? My one good friend, Buta Amin. Comrades, marathon runner, when he was going for Hajj. So the Buddha told him, Buta Amin, as any tea drink in the Kaapie, had Buta Amin a tea drink in Makkah. To fra Buta Amin for him, Buta Amin asked him, if I don't drink tea in Cape Town, for the brothers that don't understand Afrikaans, if I don't drink tea in Cape Town, then I'm not going to drink tea in Makkah. Explain, Buddha, I was confused. I don't understand what you're trying to tell me. He said, Buddha Amin, if you don't start making your hajj here already, if you're not regular now in the masjid, in the local masjid, how do you think you're going to be regular in Masjid al-Haram? How do you think you're going to be regular in Masjid al-Nabawi? If you're not making your dhikr here already, making your tilawa here already, you are not living hajj already here as a Muslim should be doing, how do you think it's just going to all happen automatically on that side of the world? It's not going to happen like that. Say, muti drunk in Kaap, dan gaat je tea drunk in Makkah. A person needs to train oneself. The deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is training for us. Ramadan is a training for us. And every year, we are the report card of our Ramadan. We are the report card of our daily lives. Look at yourself. Imam Haddad says that when a person has all these vast niyat, innamal a'malu bin niyat, the Prophet said, actions are judged according to intentions. Actions are judged according to intentions. Imam Haddad says, so when the opportunity to actually do the action comes about and you do not do the action, then you are nothing but a liar. You are a liar. You have lied to yourself. You have lied to yourself. No, wallahi, as ek geld gehad het, dan het ek, joh, dan ek het die hele masjid gerenoveer. Daar kry die man sy inheritance, renoveer die masjid. Renoveer die masjid. Nou het hy allemaal excuses. Hy koop vir my nuwe GD6, ja. Die man koop vir my nuwe kar, ja. Die man moved out op die bult nou, ja. Nou gaat ek aboe bly. Where's all the intentions you had for the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Well, wallah, if I had the money, then ek het die selle gedoen soos Buddha so en so. Jo, hy doen baie goed met sy geld. Ek sal die selle gedoen het. But when the opportunity presents itself to you, and you don't do it, Imam Haddad says, you are a liar. And your intention is worth nothing. It is zero in the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whereas you get that person who makes intentions and he will never be able to carry out any of his intentions, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala hasn't given him the means to carry out his intentions. That person will get the same reward as that person who's doing the action accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You will get exactly the same reward. When the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam was returning from one journey, and then he mentioned to the Sahaba after this expedition that, you know, that there's some people in back in Medina. We left them behind us. They never traveled with us. They never went in the jihad with us. They never struggled with us. They never saw any of the experiences and things that we had to go through. But guess what? وَشَارِكُوكُمْ فِي الْأَجْرِ. They are sharing with you in the reward of the journey. They get the same reward as you. They were surprised, a Prophet of Allah. How is it possible that these people get this? The Prophet said, it's because of the intentions. And the only reason that they're not with us, حَبَسَهُمُ الْعُذْرِ or حَبَسَهُمُ الْمَرَضِ, the Prophet ﷺ said. Because a valid excuse has stopped them. Allah Ta'ala didn't make it possible for them to do it. They have a valid excuse in the court of Allah. We must ask ourselves at 5 o'clock in the morning, at 10 to 5 in the morning, what's my excuse? What is my excuse for not being in the masjid? Are you on your way to work? Do you start work at 4 in the morning? That you can't be in the masjid and you're going to make your salah at your workplace? Because the whole world is a masjid. The whole world is a masjid for the person who can't find himself in masjid proper. But masjid proper doesn't get replaced. You can have the bigger jamaat at your workplace in the musalla, and we got the smaller jamaat in masjid proper. What has been designated as a waqf for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the actual masjid. You cannot get the same reward with the bigger jama'ah there standing on the field at the work with all your colleagues than you will get here in the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You will get reward for jama'at salah, but here you will get the 27 times more reward. That's what the ulama say. It's in the masjid proper. That's where you get your reward. Otherwise, I can make salah with my family at home and I'll have more musallis than I have in the masjid. There's more musallis at my home than there is in our masjid in the morning for fajr. If we don't take these small things seriously, Jamaat al-Muslimin, we're wasting our time with talking about the DA must fall. We're wasting our time with talking about Zionism must fall. We're wasting our time with America must fall. We're wasting our time with this and that and the UN, NATO and all these things and politics. We are wasting our time, we're wasting our breath. What our breath must go into is getting up and having the courage to pull that blanket and that duvet off yourself. Having the courage to make wudu and step outside of your home and go in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the masjid. Refined people care about Jumu'ah. They don't come for Jumu'ah like they want to come for Jumu'ah. As if Jumu'ah is just another pastime. Jumu'ah is just another weekly event. Jumu'ah is just an adah. Jumu'ah is just customary. Jumu'ah is just something we do every week. Okay, let me come in any old fashion like I want to come. Jumu'ah's reward is the greatest reward that a person receives in terms of an act where you're coming towards the Jumu'ah. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam says, the person who takes his ghusl for Jumu'ah, we have to ask ourselves, I take my ghusl for Jumu'ah. Did I take my ghusl? Did I take that niyat for the Jumu'ah? Jumu'ah is on my mind. Then he walks to the masjid as early as possible. He comes to the masjid. Then he comes to sit as close to the imam as possible. Then he listens attentively to the khutbah. He listens attentively, not one word. He's absolutely silent during the whole khutbah till the end of the proceedings of Jumu'ah. What is written for that person? The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said, that person, for every step that he took to the Jumu'ah, will get 1 year's worth of Siyam written for him. and 1 year's worth of qiyam written for him. A year's worth of fasting, a year's worth of salah, nafil salah, qiyamul layl, whatever you want to call it. For what? For every step that he took to the Jumu'ah. If you took 200 steps to the Jumu'ah, and you have followed all the etiquette that the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam laid out in this hadith, then you have 200 years worth of fasting written in your book of nafil fasting. And 200 years, not 200 days, not 200 moments, not 200 raka'ats. 200 years worth of salah written in your book of good deeds. But do we take note of this? This is a sound hadith. It's an acceptable hadith. It's not a da'if hadith. And even if it was da'if, khafif al-daf in it, then what would have happened? It would have been fine for us to narrate it for fada'il, for encouragement, for targhib and tarheeb. It would have been fine for us to have narrated it. But this is a sound hadith. And that's why the ulama say the hadith which has the most reward in it, that is of the acceptable hadith, it is the hadith of Jumu'ah. But how do we take Jumu'ah? Jumu'ah is just another pastime. What is it? Wacht is for Jumu'ah? Ja, is gaat zomaar raag, is maximaal gauw klaar. Ja, het is eerst die kosorde, het is die acneorde, ha? As ons dit maak, ek ken die tyd, ja, die imam sal al klaar wees met die praat, dan kry ons net die salah klaar gemaak het, as ons sommer raar by die deur, dan kan ons sommer gauw moe weer, dan het ons die hele lunch break free. The person who came early and made a sacrifice, he has sacrificed a camel in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The person who came after him, he has sacrificed a cow or a bull in the path of Allah. The person who came after him has sacrificed a goat in the path of Allah. The person who came after him in the next slot has sacrificed a chicken in the path of Allah. The person who came after that has sacrificed an egg in the path of Allah. And those who come later, they have given nothing and the angels don't write their names down. The angels after that close up the books and the registers of Jumu'ah and they themselves come and listen to the dhikr. They themselves come and listen to the khutbah. They themselves participate of what is happening in the majlis. And everyone after that, you have no record of your Jumu'ah. You have no reward for your Jumu'ah. Your Jumu'ah is written just by the angels here that write here. Hey, Jumu'ah gemaak. Wat 'n reward het hy gekry vir sy Jumu'ah? There's no reward for him. And those who are in the majlis, disrespect the majlis, talk during the majlis, don't pay attention during the majlis, their Jumu'ah, the Prophet said, is null and void. Their Jumu'ah is null and void. There's nothing for them. They've cancelled their Jumu'ah. If we are not going to become people of wakefulness, people of refinement, people who take note of smaller things, the basics, if we're not going to take note of the basics, then we have lost the plot, Jamaat al-Muslimin. The Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught the Sahaba the basics. And on the basics they became radiyallahu anhum wa radu'an. On the basics, what did that one companion say? A Prophet of Allah. What must I do? Testify? La ilaha illallah, I do that. What else? Make salah? Okay, I'll make the 5 times daily salah. Anything else? Anything else after that? No, everything else is voluntary after that. What else must I do? Fast a month? Okay, I'll fast. Anything else after that? Any other fasting? No, it's voluntary. What else must I do? Do hajj, this, that, etc. He said, O Prophet of Allah, I'll only do the fara'id. I'll only do the fara'id. And then he walked off. The Prophet said, you see that man there? If that man is telling the truth, if he's only going to do his basics, that man there is a walking jannati. Taiman ha jannatu. That man is guaranteed jannah already, if he's going to be truthful to what he said. The basics are the most important thing. Ask ourselves, are we on the basics? Is that time right? Is that time right? Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أما بعد إخواني في الله أوصيكم ونفسي أولا بتقوى الله فقد فاز المتقون واعلموا أن التقوى رأس طاعات وأن حب الدنيا رأس كل خطيئة وقال جل ثناؤه في محكم تنزيله أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وصحبه وبارك وسلم وقال تعالى أيضا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في دعائه في رجب اللهم بارك لنا في رجب وشعبان وبلغنا رمضان وكان السلف الصالح يدعون الله تعالى ستة أشهر أن يبلغهم رمضان ثم يدعون الله تعالى ستة أشهر أن يتقبل منا اللهم تقبل رمضاننا من قبل يا رب العالمين إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أما بعد إخواني في الله أوصيكم ونفسي أولا بتقوى الله فقد فاز المتقون واعلموا أن التقوى رأس طاعات وأن حب الدنيا رأس كل خطيئة وقال جل ثناؤه في محكم تنزيله أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وصحبه وبارك وسلم وارض اللهم عن خلفاء الراشدين المهديين أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي رضي الله تعالى عنهم وعن سائر الأصحاب أجمعين وأن معهم بأفوك وكرمك يا أكرم الأكرمين اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والمشركين اللهم بارك لنا في رجب وشعبان وبلغنا رمضان وبارك لنا في رمضان وما بعد رمضان يا أكرم الأكرمين اللهم انصر المسلمين في كل مكان اللهم انصر المجاهدين في غزة وفي فلسطين اللهم انصر المجاهدين في اليمن اللهم انصر المجاهدين في صوماليا وفي السودان وفي أفغانستان وباكستان والصين وفي هند يا أكرم الأكرمين اللهم انصر أمة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم اللهم احفظ أمة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم اللهم أكرم أمة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم يا أكرم الأكرمين عباد الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون أقيموا الصلاة اللهم ما دامت السماوات والأرض لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله استووا سووا صفوفكم فإن تسوية الصف من تمام الصلاة سد الخلل. Make sure the gaps are closed. Make sure the shoulders are in line. The heels are in line. Make sure that the mobiles are on silent. Allahu Akbar. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله الذي أنزل على عبده الكتاب ولم يجعل له عوجا قيما لينذر بأسا شديدا من لدنه ويبشر المؤمنين الذين يعملون الصالحات أن لهم أجرا حسنا ماكثين فيه أبدا وينذر الذين قالوا اتخذ الله ولدا ما لهم به من علم ولا لآبائهم كبرت كلمة تخرج من أفواههم إن يقولون إلا كذبا فلعلك باخع نفسك على آثارهم إن لم يؤمنوا بهذا الحديث أسفا. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل أعوذ برب الناس ملك الناس إله الناس من شر الوسواس الخناس الذي يوسوس في صدور الناس من الجنة والناس. الله أكبر. الحمد لله سبحانه سبح القدوس سرب الملائكة والروح. سمي الله لمن حمده. ربنا ولك الحمد حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر.
حياة وبركات الصلاة وطيبات من أحسن من أبيه وطمع بركات الأمر عليه وعلى أبيه وصحبه وعلى أبيه وعلى أبيه وعلى رسول الله سيدنا محمد وعلى سيدنا محمد وعلى أبيه وعلى سيدنا إبراهيم فتنة محيا ومماتا.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. الله أكبر. استغفر الله استغفر الله استغفر الله العظيم التواب الرحيم الذي لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم ونتوب إليه ونسألك توبة ومغفرة إنه هو التواب الرحيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا ونبينا وحبيبنا وشفيئنا وقرة أعيننا ومولانا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وأصحابه وأزواجه وذرياته وأتباعه في كل أوان وحين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين واجعلنا للمتقين إماما. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب. اللهم اهدنا واهد بنا واجعلنا سببا لمن اهتدى. اللهم اهدنا واهد بنا واجعلنا سببا لمن اهتدى. اللهم اهدنا واهد بنا واجعلنا سببا لمن اهتدى. اللهم استخدمنا لخدمة الدين وتقبل خدمتنا يا رب العالمين. اللهم اجعلنا من الذين يجاهدون في سبيلك ويأمرون بالمعروف وينهون عن المنكر وأولئك هم المفلحون. اللهم اجعلنا من الذين لا يخافون لومة لائم. اللهم اجعلنا من الذين لا يخافون لومة لائم. اللهم اجعلنا من الذين لا يخافون لومة لائم. يا أول الأولين يا آخر الآخرين يا ذا القوة المتين يا أرحم الراحمين يا راحم المساكين يا راحم المساكين يا راحم المساكين. اللهم ارحم أمة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم ارحم أمة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم في غزة وفلسطين وفي يمن وكشمير وفي هند وباكستان وأفغانستان وفي الشين وفي كل مكان يا أكرم الأكرمين. اللهم انصر المجاهدين في كل مكان. اللهم انصر المجاهدين في غزة وفلسطين وفي يمن. اللهم انصر المجاهدين في لبنان. اللهم انصر المجاهدين في سوريا وفي العراق. اللهم انصر المجاهدين في كل مكان يا أكرم الأكرمين. اللهم استخدمنا لخدمتهم. اللهم استخدمنا لخدمتهم ولا تستبدلنا يا أكرم الأكرمين. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وصحبه وبارك وسلم بفضلك دعواهم فيها.
سبحانك اللهم وتحية فيها سلام وآخر دعوة أمن الحمد لله رب العالمين. تقبل الله منكم. Yes.